Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about pitch. I'm not going to get too crazy with it because it's really complicated, but I'm just going to illustrate some main points about it so you can get a handle on it. We've all heard the saying, oh, he's got good pitch. Singers have good pitch. I don't know what's happened to the pitch with singers today, but it's gone. You know, music, singing as a instrument is gone. I just don't understand it. And all these electronic compensations just make things worse. But anyway, pitch, sensory characteristics from frequency. So we're combining a scientific measurement of frequency with a subjective evaluation in our brain. So, and that subjective evaluation occurs in many, many times and many, many cycles as we're listening to the sound. So the lower limit of pitch is the lowest frequency that we're working with. And that's the frequency that gives us the sensation of tone, okay? So that's kind of our starting point on the low end, the tone and the sensation that that tone gives you, okay? The lower limit depends on an individual physical factors of the human being. So it's more of a structural issue with your hearing, and it's more age-related. So the upper limit, obviously, is the higher part or higher frequency that can be heard, and that is the big problem structurally with human beings. And if you want to figure that out for yourself, go on the internet. There's all kinds of tests that you can take. You plug your age in and you look at the curves, and then they give you an audible test that you can do, put on your headphones, and you can actually have kind of a rudimentary hearing test on there. And I did one the other day, and I was good to 13,000, which at 65 years old, I couldn't believe. But most people at 40 years old are good up to 15. And most people that are 50 years or older, their upper limits are around 8,000 cycles for the factors that really depend on pitch determination. So it's mainly pitch is mainly a higher frequency situation. And if we're going to use a breakpoint to determine the separation, we want to start with about 1,400 cycles. So anything below that is mainly not relevant, but everything above it is in terms of pitch. It's kind of a breakpoint to distinguish, because anything lower than that, we get into feeling and bone conductance, and we're not able to separate upper limit and lower limit. So we can distinguish pitch as humans down to about 12 cycles, okay? And if you ever want to try that out, go to a drag strip and a drag track, and you'll hear frequencies in those ranges at huge amplitudes. So be very, very careful with it. So I hope that, you know, short summary of pitch gives you some idea of it. Make sure that you're able to distinguish that in your music today, and mainly in your rooms and the design of them. Thank you. Thank you for watching our videos. We really appreciate your support. And if you could give us a thumbs up for our Facebook page, that would really be helpful to us. Our room form gives us all the information about your room, length, width, height, usage, and we need you to fill that out before you send it in. Those of you that just found us on the internet and are under a time crunch, you can go to the contact section of our website, and there's a book now button so you can book a appointment with us, but make sure I have your room form to go on with it. The ebook series that we have is free. Please subscribe to that. There's exclusive videos in there so you can get an idea of your particular situation, possibly with the videos. And then our forum. We have a forum on our website. There's a lot of forums out there on the internet. Our forum will actually answer your questions and comments, so you'll be dealing directly with me through our forum. So once again, thank you for your support.